Hello and good morning to all my dear students and a warm welcome in the class of English text standard 10th. Today I am going to explain you poem 3 from your second unit. The name of the poem is A Tiger in the Zoo, written by Leslie Norris. Students, have you ever thought how selfish we are as human beings? Just look at their eyes. Do we have the right to restrict other creatures' freedom like this? We do not like ourselves to be caged or to be in one single room. We want our freedom. We want to enjoy all our rights. So, how far is it true to be cruel like this, to cage the animals? Like this, we are very much selfish enough. Students, do not get scared. This was the voice of tiger. The tigers are endangered species. Before we proceed with the poem, I would like to go through with these points. This poem contrasts a tiger in the zoo with the tiger in its natural habitat. Here, poet has shown or discussed with us two points. One tiger is kept in the zoo and the another is kept in natural habitat. This poem moves from the zoo to the jungle and back again to the zoo. Means the poem is going to start with the tiger who is placed in the zoo. In between, the stanzas will come where the tiger you will find in the jungle, and again at the end, the tiger is in the zoo. Read the poem silently once and say which stanzas speak about the tiger in the zoo and which stanzas speak about the tiger in the jungle or natural habitat. This is the only theme of the poem. The poet wants to depict the difference between the two environments. The first picture shows the tiger is kept in the zoo, and the another one which describes that the tiger is kept in the natural habitat. What makes the difference between both these environments? This is what the poet wants to discuss. Stanza first. What it says: he stalks in his vivid strips the few steps of his cage, on pads of velvet quiet in his quiet rage. The tiger moves a few steps up and down in the cage. The stripes on his body are of strong bright color. As you can see in the picture, the tiger is kept in the zoo. How much he is going to walk? Only that much, the area of the cage what is being. The tiger moves quietly on his velvety pads. All of you know that the cats, all the cat families, the tigers, they have a velvety pad at the bottom of their feet. He is full of rage in anger, but is quiet because he knows that he is helpless here. बहुत गुस्से में है, पर वो जानता है कि मैं कुछ कर सकूं वैसी मेरी कंडीशन नहीं है. दिस इज व्हाट द पोएट वांट्स टू एक्सप्लेन थ्रू द फर्स्ट स्टेंजा. मूविंग फर्दर, ही शुड बी लर्किंग इन शेडो, स्लाइडिंग थ्रू लॉन्ग ग्रास नियर द वॉटर होल वेयर प्लम डियर पास. नाउ दिस इज द स्टेंजा नंबर टू. हियर द पोएट इज टॉकिंग अबाउट द टाइगर हु इज kept in the natural habitat or is in the jungle. The poet is moved to pity for the tiger. He says that zoo is not the place where he should be. Rather, where he should be? He should be in the jungle, moving very quietly and silently in the shadows near some water source, and is waiting for a healthy deer to pass that way. As if you all are able to see the first image. See, the eyesight of the tiger, he is completely ready for his prey. Who is the prey? The completely healthy deer is the prey of this tiger who is in the jungle. So the first stanza was about the tiger who is kept in the zoo. The second one is for the tiger who is in the jungle. Moving further, again this was the sound or the voice of the tiger. He should be snarling, this was snarling, around houses at the jungle's edge, baring his white fangs, his claws, terrorizing the village. Can you see the angry tiger? The tiger who is in the rage. How his mouth is open. आप देख सकते हैं उसके white fangs, उसके जो teeth हैं, जो sharp teeth हैं, वो कैसे खुले हैं उसका claw. वो क्या कर रहा है? गुस्से में villagers को डरा रहा है. Here, poet explains that if the tiger doesn't get his prey, he would be growling at the edge of the jungle near some village. By showing his white fangs and claws, he is creating a terror for the villagers. On destroying their natural habitat, they do so for their food. वो ऐसे ही हमें परेशान नहीं करते, पर जब उन्हें अपना शिकार नहीं मिलता, तब वो आवाज करते हैं, स्नैरल करते हैं, एंड वो टेरर फैलाते हैं, जस्ट बिकॉज दे आर नॉट कैप्ट इन देयर नेचुरल हैबिटेट फॉर द फूड. हमें भी जब खाना नहीं मिलता, हमें कितना गुस्सा आ जाता है. द सेम इज द कंडीशन विथ वाइल्ड एनिमल, द सेम इज द सिचुएशन विथ दिस टाइगर हु इज बीइंग कैप्ट इन द केज. Moving further on to the fourth stanza, but he is locked in a concrete cell, his strength behind bars, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Now, if the tiger is being kept in the zoo, we all have also witnessed that. We enjoy seeing that. So, here I have shown you a few images of the tiger. Who is being kept behind the bars? उसकी जो ताकत है, वो पूरी ताकत उसकी कहां रह गई है? उस concrete cell में, उस पिंजरे में, उस cage में, वो जब उसको बंद कर दिया है, तो पूरी उसकी शक्ति उस cage के पीछे है. What the poet explains us, we'll check it out. But very sadly, very disappointingly, in spite of all his strength, he is locked inside the cage to entertain the visitors. This is our selfish motive. This is our selfish, you know, nature of human beings. हम अपने entertainment के लिए हमने उसको natural habitat से जाने से रोका हुआ है. Very slowly and silently, he moves up and down along the restricted area of the cage. But obviously, वो चाहकर भी कुछ कर नहीं सकता क्योंकि वो कहां बंद है? केज में बंद है. इसके लिए जितना केज का एरिया है, बस उतने में वो अप एंड डाउन मूव कर रहा है. ही इज नो मोर इंटरेस्टेड इन द विजिटर्स एज ही फील्स क्वाइट पावरलेस एंड वीक. बिल्कुल वो कमिंग क्राउड को एंटरटेन नहीं करता बिकॉज ही इज नॉट एट ऑल इंटरेस्टेड. व्हाई? बिकॉज ही फील्स वेरी पावरलेस एंड वीक. Do not get scared off. He is not going to come out. Okay, fine. Now, we will start up with stanza 5. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars, and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Behind the bars of the zoo, he could only hear the sound of patrolling cars. Now, the tiger could not even rest during the day because of the visitors, and even at night he remains disturbed due to the noise of patrolling cars and stare at the brilliant stars with his brilliant eyes, recalling his days spent in the jungle. He can't free himself, but he keeps on watching the brilliant stars standing behind the bars of the cage. Hope students, you all have understood the importance of not caging these wild animals just because of our selfish motives or just because of our entertainment purpose. They should be kept in their natural habitat so that they can enjoy their life. Now, coming on to the figures of speech, students, please write down the figures of speech in your textbook as and when I am explaining you. He stalks in his vivid stripes, that is alliteration because the sound S is repeated. The few steps of his cage, metonymy. Few steps represents the smallness of his cage. Moving further, on pads of velvet quiet, in his quiet rage. Metaphor, repetition, cynic joke, cynic ducky, and transferred epithet. The soft tiger paws are compared to the pads of velvet, so it is metaphor, repetition. The word quiet is repeated, cynic joke, cynic ducky, just because. Part of the body that are pads of tiger being used over here. Next one is transferred epithet, because the word quiet is transferred from the tiger of his rage. Moving further, he should be lurking in shadow, sliding through long grass. Alliteration and internal rhyme. The sound of SH, should and shadow is repeated. Internal rhyme because lurking and sliding are internal rhyming words. Moving further, near the water hole where plum deer pass. Alliteration. The sound of W is repeated. He should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. Onomatopoeia, because snarling is the sound. Alliteration, because the sound of H is there, he and houses. Metonymy, because house represents the people staying in it. Internal rhyme, because he and B are two internal rhyming words. Coming to the next, baring his white fangs, his claws terrorizing the village. Cynic ducky, exclamation is very easy because the exclamation mark you can see, internal rhyme and repetition. Why cynic ducky? Fangs and claws are the part of the body. Internal rhyme, because baring and terrorizing, the two rhyming effects are given. Repetition, because the word his is repeated. But he is locked in a concrete cell. Metonymy. Concrete cell here represents as the cage for the tiger. His strength behind bars. Irony and alliteration. The meaning over here is exactly opposite, that the tiger is helpless behind bars and without strength. So that's why it is irony. The tiger cannot be without any strength, and alliteration because the sound of B is there. Stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. Internal rhyme. The rhyming words are stalking and ignoring. ING makes internal rhyme. He hears the last voice at night, the patrolling cars. Onomatopoeia, because voice is there, is the sound. Transferred epithet is there, The word patrolling is transferred from the police to the cars with which they are closely connected. Alliteration, because the sound of H is repeated in he and hears. And stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. Synecdoche, eyes, part of body, metaphor. There is indirect comparison between the eyes of the tiger and stars. Alliteration, because the sound ST, that is stairs and stars, is there. Repetition, the word brilliant is repeated. I hope, students, that you have understood the figures of speech as well. Now, your today's task is, you are supposed to write these three question answers in your fair notebook. Write the central idea of the poem. Compare and contrast a tiger in the zoo to a tiger in its natural habitat. Explain these two lines. Do not forget to write figures of speech in your textbook. Tiger says, please save me. This is the message. That's all for today. Keep your work updated. All the very best. Thank you, students, for listening.